There was one pirate so reviled, feared, and ruthless that the crown refused any offer of clemency. He was also the most successful pirate in history. Yet incredibly, you've probably never heard of him. His name? Captain Henry Avery. On September 7th, 1695, the so-called King of the Pirates pulled off the greatest heist in maritime history, capturing the Ganjisawai, the richest treasure ship on the planet. A score worth hundreds of millions of dollars today. It ignites the first ever global manhunt, but somehow Avery and his loot disappear without a trace. Now, more than 300 years later, treasure hunters in the United Kingdom believe they're zeroing in on his stolen fortune. And a team of salvage divers think they may have uncovered the prize in a graveyard of shipwrecks off the English coast. Dead men tell no tales, but I do. And this one is a classic in the making. It's time to hit the high seas in search of the treasure of the Pirate King. We drop anchor, and the three of us prepare to dive into water that's barely hitting 45 degrees.
I'm staying warm today. Dry suit, baby.
Okay, mate, we're head down the anchor chain. If you want to follow me.
Okay, here we go.
The waters off Cornwall can be vicious, but as you can see, that's not the case right now. That's because we're working in a tight window called slack tide, with only a half an hour before the waves and current return. When they do, they'll either drag us out to sea or bash us against the reef wall.
Visibility's not too bad. Not bad, we got about 15 feet.
Okay, we've made it to the bottom. Let's cover as much territory as we can.
So we're going to search through all of these crevices.
Copy that. Okay, metal detector's hot. Here we go.
We've brought metal detectors to find whatever set off the magnetometer, which may be buried under centuries of shifting sands.
Don, you got anything?
No, not yet, Josh. We have found stuff in this sand, so let's just keep on at it.
You got it.
Wow! Hey, get over here, Josh. We got something here.
You got something? I'm on my way!
Josh, look at this. It's a musket ball.
Unbelievable! Look at that!
There's three or four here. This is amazing. I don't know about this one. Look at it. There's something strange.
It's shaved down.
Look at the shape. Look on the side. Is that what I think it is?
Is that dice? Is it a die?
I'm telling you, that's a die.
You can see the pips. Look at that. That is so cool.
I have never seen one of these before.
The musket balls are exciting, but the die is something unique. There's little that's more personal than this. Something that a sailor held in his hand hundreds of years ago.
Okay, we're in the right spot. I want to see what's deeper down here. Let's see if we can move this sand.
To move a lot of sand in a hurry, Don brings over a motorized scooter.
All right, everybody, get ready. Here we go. Let's see what's under here.
The blower moves some serious sand. Unfortunately, it moves it into our faces and takes valuable seconds to settle. But it's worth it.
Saw something up against the wall here. That's stone. That's wood! That is wood! We got a piece of wood here!
Wow!
And another! That is a small sliver of wood. That may be from the wreckage.
Do you think it's planking?
It's hard to tell, just a few pieces, but I think it may be a piece of timber.
After 300 years, there's not likely to be much left of any shipwreck. But these fragments of milled wood mean we may be exactly where we hope to be.
Josh, let's keep searching, closer into the cove.
Copy that. Right behind you.
We continue to metal detect the seabed in hopes that there's more down here.
Oh, wait. Got something here. Hold on, I got something. Got something here. Whoa, right there! That's a coin! Look at this!
That's a beauty. Wow, we are on a roll.
Unbelievable!
I just don't believe it. This is just fantastic.
Is that Latin?
That's Latin. The size of that, I'd say, that could be an English crown. Solid silver.
Unbelievable! Amazing!
We're hoping the English crown means that we're on top of a larger find. With only a few minutes of slack tide left, we continue to blow down into the sand and to frantically metal detect the bottom.
Nothing over here.
Something else here, Josh. We're getting another hit.
Oh, there! Right there! Is that a coin?
It's a coin, and I'll tell you, it's not from here. This is what we're looking for.
Let me see!
Here.
Looks like Arabic! Yes! Nice work!
Yes!
Unbelievable! Look at that! It's
what
a coin!
What a find! This is special.
We've just unearthed an Arabic coin, similar to the one Rob and Don found on their first dive here. It is a major find because Avery's big score was the Ganges Sawai, which was laden with treasure from Arabia.
We're gonna bag it, and let's look at it on the boat.
You got it! Nice find!
Beauty!
The Arabic coin is a mind-blowing discovery. Unfortunately, it's the last thing we're going to find today.
Josh, do you feel that surge?
I do. It's getting rough down here.
It's not going to be safe to be in here, mate.
Yeah, for sure. That surge is getting worse. Let's head to the boat. We'll regroup.
Right. Let's all head to the boat now. Everyone up.
The slack tide is ending, and the current begins to pull us out to sea. We quickly surface and climb back aboard the boat to get a closer look at our haul.
Let's start with that big coin.
I'm not sure. It looks to me...
It's a cross. We have a cross.
It's a cross with the four shields as well.
Yes. This is English, yes?
Yeah.
And this is who? This is...
That would be William III.
William III. There's a three right there. This puts us in the period,
that
yes?
That puts us right bang smack in the period. Couldn't be better.
And look at this. Look at the condition of it.
Well,
just
nice.
Just sitting down there. It's solid silver, so it's just clean as when it was minted.
Yep.
Worn, but clean.
Yeah. It's just amazing.
God, that is unbelievable. And then... This is a die, right?
This, yeah. Well, I wasn't sure at first.
Right, it looks like a musket ball.
Yeah,
but
I just thought,
you can see the little pinpricks in it.
It's just amazing, because I believe that gambling was actually banned on pirate ships. Looking at the shape of it, I said it was probably a musket ball, and then they've just flattened it on the sides. So
right.
That would make sense.
It's unbelievable.
And
then this coin. This was, I thought, the showstopper.
This is just amazing.
This is Arabic script here,
it's,
yes?
Isn't it? Yeah. This is definitely Mughal. There's no two ways about it.
This is
that
a Mughal coin.
That is a Mughal coin.
This is as close to a smoking gun
that is.
As we've seen.
And tied in with those other coins is cast iron proof that has got to be off of one of the Avery ships.
Certainly, this Mughal empire was huge. They were controlling a lot of trade. But taken with the musket balls and the cannons and the other coinage from the right period, it's hard to imagine this isn't part of the Henry Avery story. So, now what?
Well, now we have to continue magging that area, and we need to find the rest of that vessel.
Well, according to history, there's about $100 million worth of it sitting out there.
That would be nice.
Be really nice. This may be just the beginning.
Let's just hope so.
Nice
We've
work,
done it.
Brother.
Yeah, absolutely fantastic.
Awesome job.
Nice
Absolutely
one, Don.
Amazing.
Yeah.
Look at that.
Is this the resting place of Henry Avery's last ship? It just may be. The necessary elements seem to be here. Now, it's up to Rob and Don to find the final pieces of the puzzle.